This mini tutorial is about the histological changes seen in testes removed for gender reassignment purposes. First of all, why do patients have orchiectomies for gender reassignment? Well, the first thing is it helps reduce gender dysphoria, which may be quite distressing. And importantly, once the testes have been removed, this almost eliminates testosterone production. It doesn't completely eliminate it because the adrenal glands will still produce a very small amount of testosterone. And it will also reduce the amount of oestrogen required for feminization. Although testes removed for gender reassignment may appear grossly entirely normal, there are histological changes that are due to the feminizing treatment with oestrogen prior to the surgery. Histological changes include peritubular fibrosis with reduction in the number of tubules present, decreased spermatogenesis with very few, if any, sperm and spermatids, Sertoli cell only tubules and a prepubertal appearance of Sertoli cells with formation of Sertoli nodules. In addition, in the interstitium between the tubules, there are decreased or entirely absent Leydig cells. This is the histological appearance of a normal adult testis. The seminiferous tubules show no peritubular fibrosis, they are present in normal numbers, and there is full spermatogenesis with normal numbers of sperm and spermatids being formed. In addition, in the interstitium, Leydig cells are obviously present. In contrast, this is the histological appearance of a testis removed for gender reassignment purposes. This patient will have been on oestrogen prior to surgery. The seminiferous tubules are smaller, they are more widely spaced with expansion of the interstitium. There are tubules containing Sertoli cells only, and an obvious feature seen is the presence of peritubular fibrosis. Here is a higher power view of one of the tubules. There is quite marked peritubular fibrosis. And although there are germ cells present, there is germ cell maturation arrest and complete absence of sperm. And here is a small nodule of tubules containing Sertoli cells only. And here you can see tubules showing very marked peritubular fibrosis with either absent or very markedly reduced spermatogenesis. The other feature present is expanded interstitium virtually devoid of Leydig cells. And these tubules show such extreme fibrosis that they have been virtually obliterated.